let's continue our review of solving quadratic equations by talking about how to solve quadratic equations by factoring. And what you want to do is get zero on one side of the equation first and then factor the other side. So for example, if you have 16x squared minus 114x equals negative 14, we want to get zero on one side of the equation first. So we're going to add 14 on both sides of the equation. And so on the left side, we have 16x squared minus 114x plus 14 equals zero. And remember, when you're factoring, the first thing you always want to look for is a greatest common factor, something that'll go into all of the terms. So for example, I noticed that 2 will go into all of these because 16, 114, and 14 are all even numbers. So when you have an equation though, you have two options. You can either factor out the two or you can actually divide the left side and the right side by two. And I prefer to divide because then we don't have to carry the two with us over and over again. So I'm gonna divide both sides by two. Zero divided by two is just zero. 16 divided by two is 8x squared. 114 divided by two is two goes into 11 five times with one left over, and then two goes into 14 seven times. And then we have plus 14, two goes into 14 seven times. So we have 8x squared minus 57x plus 7 equals zero. So we have zero on one side of the equation, and we've already factored out the greatest common factor. And then we want to factor this trinomial. Now you'll notice that this trinomial has a leading coefficient of greater than one. So normally the way that we would factor that is by using the box method. So we put the 8x squared in the top left, we put the 7 in the top right, and then these two squares need to add up to that negative 57x. And we want to figure out what times what will give us, will get us this trinomial back. Okay, and so one of the things that a lot of people don't notice is that if you look at this middle number, that 57, it's actually a pretty large number compared to the other coefficients, that 8 and that 7. And if you think about it, 8 times 7, like that would be the largest number that you could get. 8 times 7 is already 56. So in order to get 57, that means that the 8x needs to be factored out into 8 and x. And then the 7 needs to be factored out as 7 and 1. But so there are two options, right? You could put the 7 here and the 1 here, or the other way around. If the 7 is here, then you're only going to get an 8x here and a 7x here. And when you add them together, that's going to give you a positive 15x. So ignoring the sign for now, that's not a large enough number to get anywhere close to negative 57. So what we want to do is actually switch it around. So I'm going to put the 7 here because I know that then the 8 and the 7 will need to multiply together. And that means that the 1 will go here. And the reason I want that is because 8x times 7 gives us a 56x. And then 1 times x will give us an x. And together, that'll get us 57x. Now that's close because it gets us the right number. It's 57, but it's the wrong sign. So remember, when it's the right number but the wrong sign, we want to switch both signs. So make these both negative. So they both still multiply to a positive 7, but then when you multiply by negative 8x, that becomes a negative 56x, and we multiply by negative x and negative 1, you get a negative x, and now this time when you add them together, you get the negative 57x. So now we've factored it correctly. So this factors to 8x minus 1 times x minus 7 equals 0. And we're going to use the zero product property because remember, anytime you have two things multiplying together to equal zero, that, that means that one of the factors is going to equal zero or possibly both. So that means that either 8x equals 1 is going to equal zero or x minus 7 is going to equal zero or both. So let's solve both of these. And so to get x alone, we would add 1 on both sides here. And so that gives us 8x equals 1. And then we divide both sides by 8. So that gets us x equals 1/8. And for this one, we would add 7 on both sides. And that gets us x equals 7. Okay. And so in order to check this, we would plug these two values back into the original. And if there are no issues, then these would be, that means that both work. So then our two answers would be x equals 1/8 and x equals 7. If one of them doesn't work, so for example, if we are accidentally dividing by zero, or if we're taking the square root of negative and we're only allowing real numbers, then we would know that those answers would not be possible. But because these don't have any issues, we're not in danger of dividing by zero, and we're not in danger of taking the square root of a negative, both answers work.